Set the tone! Yes, sir! Set the tone! Yes, sir!
Welcome back to Set the Tone. You're joined by Marty Johnson Miles. This may or may not be our second attempt at this episode.
Yeah.
But we won't dwell on it too much.
Yeah.
Yo, been a minute, boys.
Been a long while.
We haven't given the people what they want for a little while now.
Yeah. What do they want exactly?
Well, they want us, obviously.
I mean.
So we really apologize. We're back now. Hopefully, you know, more consistent than ever.
Yeah.
We had a valid reason, though.
Yeah, you we
know?
Did.
One of the team.
One person in particular.
Yeah.
You know.
Got the COVID.
Yeah, got the vid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Any clue on who that might be?
It's the absolute socialite of doom. That is Martin.
Yeah.
Barmani.
It's the Real House Husband of Auckland
number
himself.
Number one social like me.
Exactly. Yeah. It's out and about, you know.
Yeah.
You knew the entire Ponsonby Road was a place of interest, eh?
Yeah, you realised that, right?
And you were like, I don't care.
Yeah.
I'm going out.
You were just out there raw dogging.
I work here, mate. You know?
Yeah.
It's my sanctuary.
Yeah. How was it?
Ponsonby, Greyland.
Yeah, right.
You know?
Why no mask, though?
I got the Invisalign mask.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
I thought you were going to say, I just got the new teeth. I wanted to show them off.
No, it's a prototype.
Oh, right. Right,
yeah.
Right.
Yeah, it's seamless.
Nice, nice.
Almost non-existent.
Right. But tell the people what it's like to go toe-to-toe with COVID and
yeah.
Oh.
Come out the other side, mate.
Look, it was difficult.
I can only imagine.
Yeah, it was a tumultuous time.
Which one?
Yeah.
Tumultuous.
Yeah, there we go.
Is that the one?
Yeah, that's better.
That was a big word. Better? And on top of that, to increase the difficulty, he added some letters into it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You're built different.
Yeah. Bro, he, you know? This guy again, Scrabble?
Yeah.
Man, straight up. Forget about it.
Nah, look, I got to get
in trouble when you first Martin in Scrabble.
100% straight up. Bro, Martin calls audibles in Scrabble.
Yeah.
He knows all the biggest words, but then he keeps adding to it.
I'd be inventing things, you know? Yeah. I'm a pioneer of
100%.
Sorts.
100%.
Yeah. Have you played moving forward the English language? That's just never been done before.
And people just don't give you enough credit for that.
No, they don't actually. And to be fair, it's quite disheartening.
Yeah.
Knowing I'm giving.
Yeah.
And for some reason.
All you're getting back is COVID.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And, you know, so that's what it is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Take it on the chin.
Of course, of course.
Take it on the sinuses.
Yeah. Yeah, right.
Yeah. Just charge on, you know?
Nice, mate. That's good.
Well, I guess for full transparency, Marty didn't actually get COVID.
No. Well,
he danced the dance.
He did.
Yeah.
You know, and you came into close contact with four
close contact.
Couple of nights were spent together.
Look, yeah. I was contacted. Let's say that.
Yeah, you were
contacted.
Little,
you know?
Yeah. Marty got the up to fuck with. 2 o'clock in the morning, eh?
Yeah, he did.
From COVID,
Mr. I got
COVID
the old,
from the bird himself.
Yeah. COVID just ran up the guts, you know?
Yeah, oh, mate, did it ever.
And went toe-to-toe with it.
Yeah.
And 6 days later, came out on top.
Nice, mate.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say the top.
Yeah.
You definitely came out the other side. Yeah, you definitely came out.
Oh,
off the lockdown.
Off the lockdown. Yeah. Isolation. Yeah.
But like you were saying before, once this man got the negative test,
oh,
mate, you couldn't tell him anything.
No, absolutely. No. This man walked around like he's Brad Pitt.
He stopped checking both sides of the road when crossing. And exactly. I was like, Martin, you
gotta
do that.
You got it twisted. Brad Pitt now walks around like he's me.
Yeah.
You know?
Exactly. Like he's COVID-free Marty.
Yeah.
You know?
100%. Martin doesn't even indicate anymore.
He doesn't even put a seatbelt on.
100%. No, I'm invincible.
Yeah.
I'm just driving. All I do now, just out the window, just... And
one of these.
And if it's not, just
yeah, okay.
And they should know.
They should see me riding around in my whip. They should know what's what.
Well, that's COVID free Marty. You should know.
COVID free Marty.
Yeah. Not to the testing centers.
Yeah,
100%.
Just until we move on from this topic, I'm gonna keep making sure.
You know. I feel you.
But toe to toe, and here I am.
Yeah, you start wearing condoms too, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, look. Yeah.
Hey.
Yeah. Stop, when did I start?
Yeah, that's right. That's the correct answer. Correct. There it was. And
yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Nah, that's good, man. Mm. Well, look, I'm happy for you.
Yeah. Thanks, mate.
And I'm glad you're safe.
Yeah.
Hey, what was all that about? Chris, what you sure you're test negative, right?
Yeah. Because I didn't see it, so.
It was more of a an epiphany. My results came to me in epiphany.
A T-Pain sorry, second album? Yeah. How were the how were the results in an epiphany?
Oh, it just came to me. I just one night woke up.
He just felt it.
You beat the vid.
Damn. Right.
And so actually the vid could not even infiltrate my immune system.
Right, yeah.
And so
there you are.
Here I am.
Well, I reckon you know, donate your antibodies, mate.
Yeah, please. Yeah.
It's about high time we have like a 100% cure.
Yeah. Oh, nah, because then it's too immune to too many things.
So
they might not want that.
Big Pharma will come after me.
Yeah, Big Pharma.
Because to be honest, bro, you're a medical marvel. I've always said that about you.
Yeah.
You're a bit of a medical marvel.
How so?
Wow, just, you know, the things you've beaten.
100%.
Not many people do that.
I've never met someone walking around with like active brain damage. Yeah. Not
CTE.
No, you do. Technically, Marty has brain damage, right?
Yeah. Well, it's just because the weird thing about you is that you beat COVID, but you can't beat a glass of milk.
When it comes to like being a pioneer, being being a medical marvel, being for lack of a better term, a mogul.
You're right. And who's called you that?
And
mogul?
Mogul.
Finish that sentence. A mogul and what? Sorry.
And everything.
Okay.
Lost my train of thought.
You gotta give up a few things.
So it's just the active brain damage that you're talking
about. That's crazy.
The reason I said that is not because he's walking around like he's, you know, he's got his few screws loose.
That's why you said it.
It's because Marty has, you know, taken a few too many knocks on the head.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's gone past the stage of CTE.
Yeah.
Wait, you're just defying.
Who's to say that that can't be you later tonight?
Yeah, that's true.
Exactly.
Who's to say you can't join the team?
Who knows?
You can get an accelerated course as well.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
But.
Sorry, as you were saying.
I just don't understand how, you know, this virus that came from, was it a pangolin?
Something like that. Allegedly.
You know, so transferred across species.
Yeah.
But Marty can't take, you know, a glass of watered down anchor, blue top.
Now, as I was saying, like being the medical marvel that I am, being the pioneer of life that I am, being the mogul.
You just keep adding extra titles.
Yeah.
I've never heard anyone say about you.
Because we got to like preface this for the audience. Marty has anything that has, you know, a tinge of dairy in it.
Yeah, oh mate. But a lactose.
I get a whiff of dairy.
A whiff of dairy? He disappears for 40 minutes.
Yeah, mate.
And then just reappears like nothing happened.
Yeah.
But like a little bit sweaty though.
A little bit sweaty.
Yeah. You
know, like I was saying, my body picks and chooses.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. I take a small L there.
Of course.
Massive dub.
Big dub.
Big dub.
Big
know?
Dub, yeah.
Yeah. And the old pandemic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe that is the secret.
What is that?
That lactose intolerant people.
Yeah.
Just can beat the virus.
Oh, look. That could be the secret. But I've met a few lactose intolerant people and they don't seem the most, if you know what I'm saying.
They're intolerant, some of those, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
But yeah, I'm a medical marvel, as you say, a mogul, as you say. A pioneer
of life.
As you say.
Yeah.
You said all those things?
Apparently I said all those things. I just remember saying the first one.
Yeah.
Oh, just being humble.
Yeah, no.
So I would never, you know, put those tags on myself.
Nah.
I'm not one for labels and whatnot, but.
I know you're not.
I just went toe to toe and came out on top.
Nice, mate.
Jeez.
Honestly, look at you go.
Yeah.
But yeah, just to keep it, you know, all above board, Martin does not have COVID.
No, he doesn't.
Because I beat it.
Because he beat it.
In fact, Martin took it extremely seriously.
100%.
To a point that it kind of surprised us.
Yeah, I was actually shocked how seriously you did take it.
Because I got contacted, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but you also like didn't have any symptoms.
Yeah, but I got contacted.
Yeah, right. You know?
And I just had to make sure, because mum goes to, went to, you know, she's in contact with students and
children
whatnot,
and
so
stuff.
I can't really risk that.
Good on you, mate.
Yeah, so
good
I'm a team player.
Yeah, you are.
I do my part for the people.
So basically, everyone should be saying a big you're welcome. Oh, big thank you.
Big thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah. No, it's just what it is. No, I mean, they should.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to ask for it. I'm not going to take it.
Well, let me do it on your behalf, man. You know, please leave a giant thank you in the comments for Marty for all that he's done for the country as a whole.
Exactly. 100%.
Yeah. You know?
Absolutely.
He could have been out there raw dogging.
Exactly.
Spreading the vid.
No.
But you didn't do that.
He's not. Mm. He decided to stay home and isolate himself.
Yeah.
And add a few words to the dictionary.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You know?
Oh, have you played Wordle?
No, it's all the craze right now.
It is, but it'll be too easy for you, bro.
Yeah,
there's only five letters.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
Wordle. Like
that's Kitty tomato.
He's
at least 13.
At least.
If we're not talking about 13, don't talk to me.
But the thing is, he uses 10 letter words, but he adds the extra three.
Exactly.
Yeah. So Wordle, you give it a go.
It's not worth my time.
Fair enough. You might need to play it in a different language. Yeah. Maybe.
Scrabbles or nothing.
Right.
Scrabbles or nothing. You know what I mean?
You played the advanced version. Advanced,
yeah.
Straight up.
Yeah.
The plural version.
Even the name has extra few letters.
Yeah. Because I reckon keep it away from children 3 to 7.
Right.
You just next friend, you know?
Yeah.
And but that's just a bit of me.
Yeah. Have you played Wordle before?
No, I haven't. But like you said, it's all the craze. Yeah. That just reminds me. Remember when Doodle Jump?
Yeah, or Happy Feet. Not Happy Feet. What was the other
Angry
one?
Birds.
Not Angry Birds.
I remember Doodle Jump.
Yeah, I remember Doodle Jump. But it was a really hard one that you had to like go between things. And I think the founder killed himself.
Sorry, what?
Flappy Bird.
Flappy Bird.
Do you guys remember Flappy Bird?
It rings a bell, but I just can't remember the game.
You were a bird and you were flying.
Oh, tap.
Yeah.
Wait, nah.
Wait a minute.
No, I'm supposed to go. I think regardless of what direction I move, I lose this one.
But live tap, demonstration. Tap,
and you know how the birds go.
Yeah.
Yeah, they go to hover.
And it was so hard, so people were getting frustrated and like tweeting the guy who made it, and I'm pretty
sure.
Oh,
really?
Wait, really?
Yeah, no, that's ridiculous. That's ridiculous.
I think because of the like, backlash, not the backlash, but like because the attention it got and how much. And I think one first thing he did was take it off the App Store, and second thing, I'm pretty sure he killed himself. If I'm wrong, thank God, but also like that's bad on me, but I'm pretty sure that's what happened.
Interesting.
But that, you know, that took a dark left turn. Get back to Wordle.
Yeah.
And also Doodle Jump. Doodle Jump was fun. Mad fun.
Yeah.
I remember when a person in school had the highest score on my phone or my iPod and I was pissed.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you ever break it?
I think I broke it eventually, but I was pissed for that week or whatever it was.
Interesting.
Yeah. Did you ever have that where like someone else played on yours and they had the highest score?
I just, I had the clip on iPod. Pod.
Oh, did you? Not the touch, mate.
No, okay. Humble beginnings.
Yeah, what a humble guy. Yeah,
started from the bottom, you know?
Yeah.
Now look at me.
Yeah. Now look at you,
mate. Mogul.
Yeah.
What'd you call him for? Pioneer of life.
Pioneer of life, mate.
But that's not a thing anymore, eh?
Dude, it still exists, but
No. I know it's not. I know it exists, but like you know how like people
mobile
play
games.
Pioneering
mobile
life?
Games. Oh.
Yeah. No, not really. Yeah.
It's because they're just so advanced now. Like people are just playing Fortnite on their phone.
That's true.
Do you know what I mean? They're not doing these little like basic games.
Yeah.
But Wordle has kind of brought that back.
Mm.
Which I haven't played it yet. But apparently, you can only play it online. It's not an app. And you can only play it once a day, and the whole world has the same word.
Oh, that's cool. That's good.
Oh, yeah. Really?
That's cool.
So
that's
it's
cool,
like it's like a little community thing.
Yeah.
You only do it once a day, so you're not like
So wait, do you have to hit that specific time, or just whenever you log
on? So you get six. No. It's every 24 hours is a new word.
No, I understand, but you say you only play it once a day.
Yeah, you can only play it once a day because once you guess it, so or once you run out of attempts, you can't play it again.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So I think you get like 6 or 7 attempts to guess what the word is, and if you get it right, that's you for the day. If you don't get it right in any of the attempts, that's you done. You got to wait for the.
I like that, you know.
Yeah.
Once a day.
Yeah.
Global, like same.
Nice.
Level playing field sort of thing.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah.
As opposed to the shut up, mate.
Nah, what are you laughing at?
As opposed to
this is eloquent explanation.
As opposed to the constant L's on the screen.
Like Candy Crush.
It's just going in a circle, you know?
Exactly. Nah, I agree with you.
Yeah, people would have put in hours for Candy Crush.
Yeah.
Dude,
and money.
Dollars.
And dollars, bro.
Yeah, millions of dollars gets poured into that game.
Yeah, those like one of those like simulated farming apps were massive.
Yeah.
They still are.
Yeah.
Like, I still see ads on my phone.
Yeah.
Or those like war,
stuff. Building the defense base or whatever,
And because they buy so much advertising that you know they're making heaps and heaps of money.
Yeah.
Even like Farmville back in the day.
Yeah, similar to Farmville, yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
But you're building like your forts and whatnot.
Yeah.
Now that we're talking about this, it's actually going to be interesting to see where gaming goes to, because now it's got to be all on the Oculus, mate.
Yeah, I'm gonna get us a studio Oculus.
Okay.
Yeah.
That'll be good.
You guys can get your own. I can get us a studio Oculus.
Wait, you gotta stop drinking before the episodes, eh?
The thing is, can you Martin just does not. This is not his shtick. This is not his routine. This is generally.
Yeah, but also, I don't think the drinking helps.
So yeah, if you could just stop.
Stop that. Yeah.
I told you not to drink milk before these episodes, bro. Anyway,
yeah.
Speaking of Oculus,
Oculus, man. Oculus, come on, man. Yeah,
you're gonna get us the other one.
Yeah.
X-rated content. What's that like?
Like.
On the Oculus.
I love how you're doing to the question, right?
You asking me?
Well, you know, because last episode I called you a porn director. Yes. So I was just wondering what your thoughts were.
Yeah, TBC. I don't have the Oculus at the moment.
Should I rephrase? What do you expect it to be like?
Because on the Oculus store, it's not available, so. I don't know, bro. Like, I think that'd be weird.
Oh, okay. Good, yeah. Bad, unreal.
Weird, like, not my cup of tea.
So, I have a question.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, did you have a question?
I was about, you don't know that though.
Yeah, you don't know if it's not your cup of tea. You haven't tried the tea yet.
X-rated content in the metaverse yet.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because think about it. Are you in it? Okay, this is a bit of a wild question. You got the goggles on. Now, are you watching them perform or are you having it performed on you? Or both?
I don't know, bro. I haven't done my research.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean, Miles?
I do. Depends on what you watch, mate.
Like, yeah, I do. Just without his Oculus.
Yeah. Matter of fact, we can all find out.
Yeah. If you watch a, because this already exists.
Yeah, POV.
Yeah,
then you.
And it's not because I'm watching this.
No, you're not.
Right, I was actually just reading an expose on the porn industry.
An expose, was it?
How do you read videos?
Yeah, that's true.
Did the word expose have three X's in it, by any chance?
It did too.
Yeah.
So if you watch it, if you have a POV,
yeah,
of whatever, if someone's performing fellatio, it's as if they're performing fellatio on you.
Right.
How does that work though?
Because
what do you mean?
You are in the point of view of the person doing it.
Okay, let's say that exists.
It does.
Let me speak. Yeah. Okay? Yeah. Let's say that POV thing. Yeah. Okay. It exists. How, in your right mind, are you gonna sit there and be like, this is it?
How do you watch it at the moment? Watch a 2D version of it at the moment. You realize that, right?
Well, hey, now, firstly, relax.
Imagine making that 3D. Yeah.
So now all you're doing is literally leveling that up to 3D.
I see the science behind it.
I see the appeal.
I
see how it works.
Yeah. And so the other version of it is, I guess you're just in the room and you're watching the actors do their thing.
Yeah.
As if you were watching it on your screen, but now you're in the room.
Now you're in the room, yeah.
Is that cool?
That's a cuck, is it?
Yeah. But is it cuck though? Because if I'm watching it on my screen, am I cuck?
I don't know. Like, you know, personally, I'm not.
No, because that's the most standard version of porn. It's just watching a man and a woman go at it.
Yeah.
But now because you're in the room, it turns into a cuck category.
Mm.
So, you know, it raises important questions.
It does.
Yeah.
And so it's going to be interesting what happens.
Order three. Oculuses?
Yeah, three. Yeah.
Oculi.
And a subscription to.
Yeah.
No, I want to get it for on like the ski, like the slalom and whatnot. You know, the
Compton ski. You're saying one thing, you're doing another.
No, that's the Compton skiing, bro.
Yeah, that'll be fine. Or like tennis.
Tennis, yeah. Essentially
Wii sports, but
in your face.
Yeah, in your face. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Imagine going to
as man said, Wii in his face.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Imagine going to watch a Grand Slam.
Yes.
In person.
Actually, a Grand Slam in person, mate. You know what I mean?
Back to the subscription, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That'd be unreal.
Yeah.
That would be unreal. Yeah.
But yeah.
Speaking of Grand Slams, I watched a TikTok the other day of, this is where all my topics come from now, from now on, boys.
Yeah. He's a TikTok pioneer over here, mate.
Yeah, exactly. I watched a TikTok the other day of a girlfriend of one of the top ranked US tennis players.
Yeah.
And she was basically saying, this is what it's like to be the girlfriend of an athlete.
Right.
Especially in a sport that's, you know, global.
I found myself on that side of TikTok as well.
Did you?
But like different sports.
How fucking unreal.
Insane, eh?
Dude, it is. That's why I put that up there. Is it better to be an athlete or be dating an athlete? And honestly, I'm changing course. It's better to be dating athlete.
100%.
You don't have to train. Nah. You don't have to diet. Nah. You get to go around the world. You get to shop for days, meet all the cool people. Man.
But you get none of the...
Valerie Adams, what's up?
Yeah, but you get none of the feeling.
You wish, mate. You wish.
You don't get the feeling of success and the accolades.
True. And the adoration.
Yeah. Imagine sitting next to Ronaldo while he receives his Ballon d'Or.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's true. But I don't have an ego.
If you're dating a... yeah. Are we just lying like that?
The one that dates, the version that dates an athlete doesn't have an ego.
Nah, I reckon your ego would be amplified. Imagine...
True.
You'd literally, if you were dating a high profile and you got to, you were like in their limelight.
Yeah.
You would probably be like...
You'd convince yourself that it's,
yeah,
you deserve it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then next step, you'd probably go to the NBA and be like, why am I not on at least a 10-day contract?
Yeah.
Given I'm on the same level as...
But I'm dating a female athlete.
Yeah, but you still think you're on the same level.
Right.
Even though you're clearly not.
Yes. I've seen that happen actually with Steph's wife. I feel like she has convinced herself that all the fame and you know, the adoration that she gets, she's sort of generated herself.
Yeah.
Which, you know, without being disrespectful...
I think to a certain extent she has.
To a certain off extent
the back,
she has.
Obviously off the back of...
Being Steph Curry's wife.
Yeah, but she's still like on a different route. It's not she's not like in a sporting realm.
Yes, yes. You
know, she's doing her thing. But yeah, definitely off the back of... Respectfully.
Yes, respectfully. But come on, like, it's the most famous player in
the world. Yeah, 100%. Like, yes, definitely off the back of him.
Yeah. But, man, the life looks great.
Oh, 100%.
She is literally... She's at Wimbledon and she gets to like go shop in London and then go watch his games and... Man, strawberries and cream on the sidelines.
It's not Novak.
It's not Novak. No. It's like a young American dude.
Yeah. The only thing I would kind of
be cautious about is like, you've got to be there to support all the time, which can be a bit annoying. Imagine like, being a wag for someone at Manchester United. I don't want to watch that bum ass team.
But Manchester United not good anymore? Man, you not good?
Oh.
But also,
we're struggling to get one or draw with bum teams.
Ah, damn. You know? Okay. But that's a little bit different. Oh, I guess they do travel quite a bit. But something like tennis or golf, you literally have like 200 days of travel guaranteed every single year at the best locations. Or Formula One even.
Yeah.
You know, she gets to go to Australia, England, Saudi Arabia, all that stuff.
When, let's say it's, I'm Lewis Hamilton's boyfriend.
Yeah.
Who?
I'm Lewis Hamilton's boyfriend.
Yeah. Okay,
yeah.
That's a deep cut for our TikTok followers.
100%.
Oh, yeah, because it's not going on the... Yeah.
I will then have to sit at that Grand Prix.
What's wrong with that? A couple hours of your day?
That's not a couple hours, bro. That's a whole day event.
Grand Prix is?
Yeah.
Yeah, but then you get a week in Monaco, bro.
Yeah, but that's like a small price to pay for your lifestyle.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, okay. That's pretty unreal.
Yeah.
And it's like, especially with... That you just have to go to the events. You don't have to go to the fucking gym with him. You don't have to go to practice. I got to show up at a glamorous tennis match or a Grand Prix. Okay, whatever.
What?
I don't care. Catch what you got.
Grand Prix. Slightly different tech. Same, same realm. It's like obviously these high profile athletes and celebs and whatnot.
Yeah,
it's like hard for them to find love, right?
Yeah.
Like, I mean...
It's not hard for them to find partners, but it might be hard for them to find...
Yeah, like, well, that's what it seems.
Right.
How real do you think that is? Like, do you think it's more common than not?
Sorry, what's the question?
That they're not actually in love? Because how, like, they get... They're famous and whatnot.
Yeah.
And they pretty much have the pick of the crop.
Depends, you know? It depends whether they've found this person after they've become huge.
No, that's I'm talking afterwards.
Simply after.
Simply afterwards.
Okay.
Because beforehand, it's you know.
And also, is the partner equally famous, or are they just?
I think that's the primary question.
I think let's say no.
Okay. So they're just like a standard, a regular person.
From the outside looking in, that looks like a clout chaser sort of thing, right?
It depends. It really does depend.
Yeah.
It can be a clout chase thing, but also like
that's the general consensus, right? That everyone's like, oh, okay, this guy can get anyone he wants, so he's just getting the hottest one or whatever, you know?
Yeah.
And so I guess what I'm trying to ask is, do you think there is a lot of cases out there where it's actually like
genuine?
Genuine.
Yeah,
I think so. I don't know if a lot, but I think there's like a good chunk, maybe. But right. but quite often the most successful ones are typically the ones that have been there since the start. You know how like you were with me when you were shooting in the gym, like absolutely. That whole story. Kobe and Vanessa and
also a lot of them aren't, stuff. You know.
A lot of them what?
Aren't. A lot of them aren't.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A lot of them come after the fame and whatnot.
I'm trying to think of an example of a famous athlete with a regular partner that happened after.
It's also like hard to gauge like, oh, are they truly in love? You know?
Yeah,
sure. Because that's, because like maybe like even if like initially the intention wasn't necessarily, you know, for love, for the person.
Yeah.
You're human, so you can develop that over time.
Of course. Yeah.
So, you know, it's hard to judge like whether or not that's, oh, no, that's not true love.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, what about something local, like Beauden Barrett and his wife? So he was obviously...
I don't know their origin story.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
I thought he was like all black level already before he met her.
I'm pretty sure that's the case.
Yeah.
But yeah, because she's quite up there in the...
Yeah, she was social. A chartered accountant, right?
Yeah, she's quite up there, huh?
Wasn't she a chartered accountant?
Yes, like regular stand.
No,
I mean,
yeah, but like, you know, she's not like a celeb.
Well,
she's
not like the social kind of.
Yeah, like a social light like me.
Yes.
Yeah, like yeah, exactly. Yeah, I hope right. she's yeah. safe. I hope she's being safe yeah. right now. Yeah. But yeah, but I think, has that come off the back of being Beauden Barrett's wife, or has that always been the case? I'm asking you like I expect you to know this.
Yeah, and I'm answering like I don't know this. You know, I'm not too sure on that one. So like, okay, that's probably not the best.
Yeah, right. I don't know.
And maybe DC as well, DC and his wife?
So DC and Honor. So DC was a black...
Okay, time out. He's what, nah, just time out. Mata, just time
no,
out.
No, I was trying to
figure... You can't use that word.
No, I was trying to figure out what the hockey team is.
Blackstick.
Nah, I'm pretty sure it's the men's one.
Yeah, they're both Blackstick.
Oh, they're both Blackstick. Yeah. Oh, she was a Blackstick.
Oh,
so they're both athletes. Like,
same
on the
as
come
Richie's, hey? Richie McCall's wife?
Yeah, she was a Blackstick
yeah,
as well.
Yeah.
So,
Yeah, so that's... I mean, look, if do you know any examples?
I don't know...
Of actors, okay. Oh, I guess Ronaldo, and she seems nice. What?
There's no way if Ronaldo was a plumber, those two would get together.
Do you not reckon?
No, bro, she worked at a Gucci store.
But that's not a huge thing. What do you mean?
And bro,
I'm just gonna pause you right there. Yeah. No disrespect to our plumbing viewers.
Yeah, facts,
our plumbers.
Facts.
Because this no, guy
yeah,
here.
Yeah, that's crazy.
This guy
that's
here crazy. Just like, you know. this guy's a corporate lawyer, you
yeah,
know?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
So he just like,
just exactly. Look, yeah. So yeah, he really. I'm sorry that I didn't pick that up. Actually,
yeah, yeah. We're here for the people. You know, he's here for.
Firstly, that's the backbone of the New Zealand economy.
They're
okay?
the backbone of Aotearoa.
Yeah.
The backbone of New Zealand.
The backbone. Yeah, you did. So I don't know why you turned your back on them.
Yeah, but he was like the flashy, like the showcase.
Yeah,
he was a sales rep.
Yeah, he was. You were in the toilets, fixing up, and doing all that.
Nah.
Yeah.
He's not part of the backbone. But sorry, carry on.
Carry on. Yeah, not the best footballer in the world.
Yeah. There's no way she would even have a second class.
But can I just stop you right there? He's still a piece.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
So that's where my thing comes into. Like, okay, maybe out the gate, like, obviously, they wouldn't have been able to have that introduction.
Yes.
If he was, let's say...
an accountant.
An accountant.
Yes.
You know, for a...
He might shop at Gucci.
Nah, but that's what I'm trying to say.
So yeah, but... Yeah.
Yes.
It really depends on like the social status of the girl.
Right.
Because there's just no way, like, I don't know, a teacher would meet like this chick.
Yeah. Oh,
we'll let that one slide. Yeah, teachers can.
Yeah. I thought you were saying famous athletes can't meet teachers. I was like, yeah. What if when they drop their kids off?
No. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, it's. But no, if they weren't famous.
Right.
The teacher would likely go after the.
So my question to you is, and specifically in Ronaldo's case, say he was not the mega star that he is, but you know, he was some sort of businessman and he just happened to pop into the Gucci store and he laid down a bit of game. He couldn't secure homegirl? Why?
He's a piece though. So he's a piece.
Yeah.
No, you know why?
He still looks like Ronaldo.
So remove the status.
Yeah.
Yes.
He's still a piece.
It doesn't matter.
So she's just dating him for the status.
Yeah, bro. Honestly, money makes anyone look handsome.
Yeah, but he's already handsome though.
No, I understand. But there's just a
different
thing when you have status.
Yeah.
You just can't. It doesn't matter how
old
you are.
Yeah, no, that is true.
That's true.
That's why the intention. Yeah. The intention of things is quite hard.
Yeah,
is. But I'm just saying, like, humans, like, you can develop that regardless of your intentions out the gate.
Mm.
I'm sure, like, over time, if someone's endearing and whatnot, and you really do mess with them, but also the money could still, even if you don't vibe with them.
Yeah.
You still like try.
It's still fun.
You know.
Yeah.
But also, like, that's not gonna last. So. And that's probably why you hardly see them last year.
But Ronaldo and his girls lasted quite a while.
Hopefully, for like 10 years.
10 years, that's a long time.
Well, I think 10 years, like maybe.
Yeah, going on, yeah, pretty close.
10 years, pretty long time.
But anyway, what I did want to say
that's
is.
That's the age gap.
Yeah,
the age gap. And I think that's the secret.
It is like 10 years. But like, the other thing I want to say was, she's a pretty girl working at a high profile store in Madrid.
Yes.
Right, how many other football players would be hitting her up? Do you know what I mean? So this handsome dude in a suit coming in, it doesn't matter. I got like 16 other players in my DM.
Yeah, that's a fair shout. You know?
That's a fair shout.
And she was like, I'm going to just pick the best one.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So Messi and Ronaldo come at the same time.
Nah, Ronaldo. You're going for Ronaldo, aren't you?
Okay.
That's a fucking Greek god. Respectfully to
Bezos
Messi.
And Ronaldo come at the same time.
Bezos is jacked, bro.
Yeah, but I'm still going with Ronaldo.
Ronaldo's got the balance of peace and loaded.
Yeah.
Peace? Oh, like he's a peace.
Yeah.
Right, yeah.
Whereas Bezos is he's
just loaded.
Yeah.
But yeah.
But also, Bezos loaded is different to Ronaldo loaded. Let's make it very
clear. Yeah, but also.
You got to put up with that. Yeah.
Respectfully. Yeah.
Fair.
Yeah, I reckon.
Oh, yeah, so the actors that met someone after.
Oh, yes, please.
Matthew McConaughey and Matt Damon.
They're together?
No, yeah.
Oh. I think they're both famous, bro.
Four formation
of yeah.
No, they respectively found partners after they were famous.
Really?
Yeah.
And that's worked out for them?
It's like the most random way. So, like, kind of like Ronaldo, but a little bit more humble. So
okay.
Like, Matthew McConaughey just went.
Like a gap. Not a Gucci store, like a Gap, maybe.
No, just went to like a random mom and pop cut-in store.
Yeah.
There was this chick serving it. And he's like, hey, what's up?
Really?
But do you know what Matthew McConaughey's wife looks like?
No. Right, that's the secret.
That's the indication of someone that married for life.
Hey, you see, you're very superficial, you.
Yeah, you don't know that, dog. You don't know that. You know?
Matthew McConaughey's wife's a piece, too. So she could be...
Oh, so she is a piece.
Yeah, she could be like a Mark Clooney.
Yeah.
Now that's a bit.
Why?
I don't know if that one's a love one.
They split up, didn't they?
Did they split up?
Are they together?
George and Mark Clooney.
Mark was not paying attention to any of that.
Nah, are they together?
George and Mark Clooney.
Yeah, I heard those two names together. I was like, "That's what team do they play for?" No, nah, they're still together.
Oh, they're still together. Okay, yeah. My bad. Okay.
Sure.
So you think she married for clout there? Yeah. But isn't she like the daughter of some like royalty or something? I don't know. I'd be making stuff up, bro.
You'd love to marry into like a Sheikh's family, eh?
Absolutely.
Emirati.
Oh.
Forget about it.
I'd go into like an Egyptian family. You know what I mean?
Egyptian family. Why?
Yeah. Oh, I like pyramids and whatnot. You know what I mean?
I don't think they get to own them, bro.
Yeah, but you know, go to the Gizas and whatnot. You know.
The Gizas. I would love to marry an Emirati.
Yeah.
If you're watching, let me know.
Yeah, I don't think people
realize how good life is in Dubai for someone that's technically from that region.
Absolutely. You recently found out, thanks to me.
Did. Yeah, I did.
Yeah. It is amazing, Martin.
Yeah.
Do you know how good it is?
I've been.
Right.
I've seen it firsthand.
Have you actually been to Dubai?
Yes.
You would have fit right in too.
I've been like four times.
Where was the most recent time?
Was the Burj there?
Nah, it wasn't there.
Oh,
because
okay.
I haven't been able to go back.
So you didn't go to Dubai then? Yeah.
No, but I haven't been able to go back.
You went to old Dubai.
I haven't been able to go back to the Middle East in a while because I might not be able to come back. You know,
it might be a one-way trip.
One-way trip, you know.
Yeah. So life for an Emirati in Dubai is unreal, bro.
Yeah.
They get a free house.
House.
Yeah. They don't have to work, pension for days.
They get a free life, man.
Free life, essentially. You know? Yeah. It's pretty unreal.
Yeah.
So, yeah. No. Please let me know any Emirati woman listening. Yeah. You know, I'm very much available for you.
Yep.
Should we start the pod?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. What do you want to talk about?
You shoot one off the rank. You know?
Okay.
I don't know what that thing was.
Did you guys see the Oscars nominations?
Yeah, next one.
Nah, honestly, I got a question.
I haven't, but I've paid no attention.
I know, that's why, exactly.
Yeah, go on. Yeah,
I have a question. Did you watch it? Did you see the... Yeah, of course. That's stupid. Why don't movies that we watch ever get nominated?
Why don't?
Yeah. Spider-Man's not nominated.
Yeah.
Spider-Man's a great movie.
That was a controversial pick.
man, what's doing there?
It's almost, yeah, it's almost like superhero movies can't get picked.
Why?
Because it's almost like it's too fake.
What do you mean?
No, like, you know, like, no, like, it's obviously, it's clearly like a
you made realize up. La La Land was about a woman dating a fish.
I never watched that movie.
Yeah. Wasn't it? Or the other one. Was it La La Land?
That's Nemo.
Shape of Water.
That's Nemo.
Was she dating a fish or something? She fell in love with a fish?
She fell in love with, like, a fish-like creature.
See what I mean?
That's more realistic than
Spider-Man guy like this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, I when I think of, like, Oscars and stuff, I think of, like, movies that, like, I'll say movies that move you.
Okay, here we go.
No, but like movies that
he's
like
right though.
No, like movies that like you can.
Spider-Man moved us.
No, but like movies that you can like somewhat relate to, or like at least
all the above.
Aspire to be.
Yeah.
Or you truly take something away from that you can apply to your life.
Me dating a fish.
Ah, I'm thinking like other movies like
like what? Name the last Oscar movie, Oscar winner, nominated, whatever.
I'm not saying I watch like Oscar worthy movies.
Yeah, right.
But when I typically think of that and that kind of award thing, I'll be like, but yeah, these are the kind of movies like Django and those kinds of things. Like
I almost like Django, yeah.
Almost like real life. I mean, that is real life, but like, you know, in terms of movies.
My thing is that this is the award. This is the award for movies, right? Like, this is what you want. Why are we suddenly being elitist? Why are we excluding all these great films?
I think there should be like different categories.
There are. I don't know if you've ever seen the Oscars. No. Martin, let me school you on what the Oscars are about, mate. So it's an award show, right? And
no,
actually,
like,
it's actually. He's just like, guys, I've got the fix for the Oscars. Categories. thoughts on some categories.
Let me finish.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. All best soundtrack. Now, what do you reckon, bro? What do you reckon?
I feel like the track I was going to go down was still wrong. I'll just cut my losses there.
No, my question is, how many movies have you watched in the past year?
A couple.
And any of the nominated films?
Did you watch any of them?
Nah. Yeah.
So how do you know they're bad?
Because I didn't watch them.
Yeah.
And if
also,
they were good,
some of the movies you put forward for us to view aren't.
Nah, but do you know what I mean?
If there's like, Oscars for worst movies.
It's like, Spider-Man is a great, like, visual, like, and, like, it's a good film to experience.
Yeah, like, it's entertaining.
It's entertaining.
Yes.
But it's not a good film.
Why? I think it's a good story.
Barely. It's
predictable. No, see, like, yeah, those. Like I was saying, just repeating myself. When I think of Oscar, I think like a real story.
Categories,
like,
yeah.
You know, like, yeah, categories. But like something with substance, not like superhero stuff or that, you know.
So what did that say to those guys though? Because they deserve some recognition, you know?
But you know, almost, like you could almost, like for me, like you could almost like do like, what's her name? Lois Lane and Superman story.
No fighting and stuff.
Like take out the blue and red costumes. Just put them in the everyday, like, just normal scenario.
Yeah.
And I feel like just automatically, I'll be like, that should already be in, like, get nominated.
That's a great shout, because that's what happened with the Joker. Joker won, but it was no, like...
you know, so you almost remove that, like...
See, I don't know.
That's what I mean when I say, like, what I'm saying.
Yeah, the Joker... And
it's
also a superhero film, but there's no superhero antics.
Like, yeah, that's like
there's
if
no
you could,
Batman,
you,
nothing.
You could almost if you remove all that like thing that's just, like in your face and just strip it down and make it seem very human.
Yeah.
Then that's elite as well. If you can still have the superhero like undertones, but it seems very human.
But now it just feels like an award for serious movies and not fun movies.
No, doesn't have to be serious.
It doesn't have to be serious. Like Jojo Rabbit got heaps of awards.
Oh, right.
Because it's like.
But see, again, that's like a. It's like a think piece almost, you know, that's it's commentating on whatever society and all that stuff. Nah, I don't want that. I want fun movies.
So,
so like I said,
I think
categories.
Well,
yeah.
Kanye West gets a Nobel Peace Prize.
No, that's wild. No, that's crazy. But no, according to your world, Grammys should only go to conscious singers and rappers.
That's what it is.
Nah.
Go.
I don't like that. No, that's not true because Will Smith's won a Grammy. And that man did not win it off the back of a conscious song.
You know, yes, he did.
What? Which one?
Your parents just don't understand.
It was just a, it was a
I
conscious.
Went deep that one.
It was Miami that one, didn't it?
Oh, was it?
I think so.
He's won multiple Grammys though.
Oh, okay. But you know what I mean? Like what were like the Black Eyed Peas and stuff? Oh, I mean, they might have won it for a conscious. But I don't know. Like, I just think fun should also be rewarded as opposed to just like social commentary and serious and blah, blah, cinematography and screenplay. And obviously, like you said, categories are a thing. Well, maybe a category for fun.
Yeah. That could be the compromise.
Yeah. So you're on the right track,
John. 100%.
John D's Oscar for fun movie.
Yeah.
They don't call me a pioneer of life for no reason. You know what I mean?
Exactly. Yeah. I'll sit on you, bro.
I do things like this.
Yeah.
But okay, this is a slight segue. Similar tone. No, because like, you know.
Why does I slight segue? Man, that. Ukraine, eh?
What about the World War III, eh? Speaking of good movies.
Jeen-Yuhs.
Yes.
Yeah.
So now I need more of that.
Yeah, yeah. For anyone that doesn't know, what is Jeen-Yuhs, Martin?
Jeen-Yuhs is essentially a...
It's a website where you go and look up rap lyrics.
Yeah. Jeen-Yuhs.
Yeah.
Is essentially Kanye's come up story. Yeah. And... Or Kanye's story, essentially, not just the come up.
Yeah.
Well, actually, I'm not too sure because only one episode so far.
Yeah.
So that is like the early stages of his career. So it's a documentary.
Yeah. Well, it's a, yeah.
What's another word? Because like
I asked the wrong person to tee it up. Hey.
It is a documentary.
No, but was there another word for it? Like
nah, docker. Yeah.
Yeah, docker. Yeah, it's a docker on Kanye West.
Yeah. It's a, yeah.
Something like that, yeah.
So it's all shot by one of his good mates that followed him around from a very young age.
Cootie. Good for bro. He's the man.
Honestly, that's crazy, eh? And sorry, I was just gonna, basically before we get into it. It starts or picks up where Kanye is essentially on his way to become the super producer, right? Like he's already done H to the Izzo and he's done a lot of the blueprint and stuff, but now he's really committed to making it as a rapper and one's taking him seriously.
Yeah.
And that's where the story begins.
Yeah.
Just before we discuss Jeen-Yuhs,
I really like great content from minorities.
Yes.
Where like a lot of people, like a lot of black directors on the come up would be labeled visionary simply because they're black.
Yep.
But their actual stuff's not good.
Yeah.
Did
you say Jordan Peele? That's crazy. Yeah. Nah, why did you do that?
What was that? Black Western you...
Wait, that was good. No, that was good. No, you guys are haters,
that was just
man.
Purely visionary.
But what did you say? Black West?
The Black Western.
Black Western.
Oh, yeah, that was garbage.
Nah, y'all are haters, man.
The Harder They Fall, eh?
Genuine trash.
Everyone, leave in the comments. If you've seen The Harder They Fall, was it good or was it bad?
And if you've seen it, I apologize. Yeah.
Sidebar. It's like the whole thing with, you know, Crazy Rich Asians.
Yeah. But
I mean,
okay, firstly, I've never seen it, but secondly, I just think they were happy to get one, bro.
Nah.
Let them be happy.
We should be happy to get one that's good.
I understand.
I prefer,
But
I don't like them just checking boxes, you know?
But you got to understand, with African-Americans, with black people, they can now demand good because they've passed the point of happy to get one. They've got mad, you know what I mean? So like back when Tyler Perry started making movies, they would have been like, I was just happy to get one. And those wouldn't have been good movies. Yeah. So Crazy Rich Asians is just, you know, hey, we're happy to get one. Now they got Shang-Chi and whatever, I don't know, other ones. So little, you know, I think that makes sense.
But also like, I mean, yeah, like I'm with him on this one.
Yeah. Okay.
Like just seeing like, because that almost takes opportunities away from guys like Cootie and these guys who are like genuinely good at what they do, but because they're not, then they haven't made it. Like let's say Kanye. Kanye is a gun producer.
Yeah.
He didn't get his shot, or he wasn't given a shot as a chance as a rapper.
Yeah.
You guys got guys like Cootie who just don't get a chance at all.
Right.
And they're like elite at what they do, but there's guys who are like good actors or who are in and around production and whatnot.
Yeah.
Who have a name as an actor or just being around the scene. And so because everyone's like kicking up a fuss saying, hey, give our minorities a go, they just give it to the guy who's at the top, who's not necessarily the best, like a Cootie or whatever, what they do. But because they're at the cusp of like stardom, but not necessarily as a director or a producer, they get given the shot.
But
and then you get things like that Black Western, where like respectfully, like that was cool, just like cool for them, but it wasn't good. I'd watch something by Cootie,
but
10 times out of 10 over that, you know?
Well, that one's a little bit different, but my pushback
it's not.
My pushback to the other minorities would be, you got to go with the most mainstream one because that's the one that has the best chance to succeed.
Yeah, but I hate that.
What was that Netflix thing that just killed last year? That wasn't mainstream.
Squid Game.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's also that's foreign. Do you know what I mean?
No, you're just going with the minorities thing.
Yeah. Like, no. Like that's like a foreign language series.
Also, it's like it's almost like alternative. So they.
I guarantee you exactly what you're saying now.
No one's really got to get it.
Yeah,
we'll try it, but we'll see.
Yeah. It could be, yeah.
Like, I'm pretty sure that's what happened.
Yeah, so, yes, exactly. Yeah. So it could have been like, yo, this is a foreign language thing. We just want to expand our audience. Whatever. Korea is massive for us. Let's put this on. And then it obviously just caught fire and went nuts.
Exactly.
Right? But my thing is, when in the Western world, in the English speaking world, in order for a minority led movie, traditionally speaking, it's not how I think, but traditionally speaking, in order for it to have the best chance to succeed, it has to have the most mainstream characters. It just has
that's
to.
That's the thing we don't like.
That's what we don't like.
We almost think that you don't need that.
Exactly.
Yeah, given I agree with you.
Given the success of Squid Game,
no
mainstream guys, you know, and they were trying for years to get their shot, and they got their shot. And
I think those guys, some of them are quite mainstream in the Korean world, though.
Yeah, but look, it caught fire internationally, you know.
Yes, because it's a great concept.
No, it is great, but like, and it wasn't mainstream. It wasn't a mainstream director. It was a mainstream cast.
Mm.
Although in their hometown, they might have been.
Yeah.
Like, back to the point, like, I'd rather see the grassroots guys,
of course,
absolutely kill it. Because, like, off the back of what's come out recently,
yeah,
there hasn't been quality from the minorities. There's just been, like, there's not much substance there. They're just checking boxes.
I understand that,
yeah.
And I think both can exist at the same time. I just think, in order to reach the mainstream stratosphere, the quote unquote. Star has to do it first. Even locally, say for example, like Pax, he's coming out with a new show. That's good for us because in 5 years' time, we can do that off the back of, like, he's sort of breaking the door down so that we can walk through it. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. But for all intents and purposes, that looks like a well-produced show.
Right.
Yeah.
But and it's also got the most mainstream, ethnic comedian actor in New Zealand, right? So he has to do it in order for them to go. Oh yeah, we'll take a chance on these guys.
But it's almost two very different markets. Like,
I think because
it's super niche here.
Yeah,
you can almost just afford to check that box, and it's probably going to be good. It's so much harder for him to get to the top.
Yes,
as a minority, and like actually good at what he does.
Yeah,
because like there's no one else doing it, so he's not necessarily going to get the chance. But over in the States and stuff, the audience is big.
You know what they're like, bro. Like let's go back to the Asian example. The population is still so small that they have to be like, okay, we have to put Ronnie Ching in this, or you know, I don't know who any other Asian big Asian actors or producers. Yeah. And then if Crazy Rich Asians does numbers, which I think it did, then they can go, okay, we can take a punt on maybe some more younger, unknown, talented actors for the next Asian film, and maybe we can go a little bit darker, a little bit more serious, not as fucking stereotypical, whatever. But I just think that's how it works.
I hear that, and that's pretty much, you know, I get that. But also, like, how often do, when guys make it to the top, how often do they spread their wealth and knowledge, spread their connects, you know? Like, it doesn't matter if you're a minority. You get to the top, once you experience that, you almost just keep your circle, right? And you just keep feeding the guys around you. And so, as much as people want to say, like, I'm on the come up, when I get there, I'm going to do this, this, and that.
Yeah.
Most of the time, you don't get that chance.
Right.
Like, once you're up there, and they'll let you stay there.
Yeah.
But within these constraints, you know, within these parameters.
But I don't think we need that handout. I just think, if someone that looks like us succeeds, it puts us in a better position to succeed.
Yeah, no doubt. Yeah, but that's just saying, like, it's just better than nothing.
Yeah. I think our primary gripe is with the industry.
Of course. Yeah. And I get that. Yeah. It's like, hey, look, take a chance on us being good, not us being a minority.
Yeah, exactly.
And I get that.
Yeah. Because they're taking chances on all these, like, respectively, these white, like, directors and producers and stuff. And a lot of them flop.
100%.
But they still cut the check. They still get paid. They still feed their families with, like, big money.
Yeah.
And they're not willing to risk, like, minimal budget on
a minority
on, like, a Jeen-Yuhs or something like that, you know?
Yeah.
And there's plenty of those around.
Yeah.
Hey
man, that's the world we live in. Oh, yeah. You just gotta navigate that.
Yeah. Not to say that can't happen, it won't happen.
Yeah.
But frick, I mean.
Jeen-Yuhs. Jeen-Yuhs.
This is a great documentary for anyone, you know, that still kinda has that, like, dream in them to like that they want to chase.
100%. That chip, the chip on your shoulder.
Yeah, yeah. The chip on your shoulder.
And like, no matter what you do, if you're in the creative field, yeah. But even if you're not, even if you're trying to make it in the corporate world mm. and you know athletics, anything,
you can translate it to anything.
Anything.
You know, it's yeah. just copy and paste into any walk of life, whatever you're trying to do.
Yeah.
And that's just the first episode.
Yeah, I know. It's literally insane.
Like, cause you like. Obviously, hindsight is you know,
yeah.
we have hindsight. We have the luxury of that for this particular thing. And you just see these bangers just being like shut down. Not even shut down, just not given the time of day. You know, he puts the CD in. He stops a song that's already playing, puts the CD in, and starts blasting what we know now as
All Falls Down.
All Falls Down, an absolute, like, an all time
song.
And they're just like, can you just
ignored it.
Yeah.
I think like what makes that so impactful is you see the end result of Kanye's career, you see how big that song got.
Mm.
And when he showed it to someone for the first time, their first reaction was
it was no reaction. Like not even in the time of day.
Yeah.
And like it was still played and you hear it and like you don't it's just crazy how.
And the thing is, he didn't just show it to anyone. He showed it to someone that is an expert in the music industry.
100%. Yeah.
He's
and not just one, just multiple people that were in the industry, you know?
So he's at the biggest record label in rap at that time.
Yeah.
And he's playing it for them and they're just completely ignoring it. And so
he went to the Mecca of rap.
Yeah.
Left his hometown to pursue this.
Exactly.
And just not given the time of day.
Exactly. You know? And so anyone with the absolute unrelenting self-belief, without the absolute unrelenting self-belief that Kanye has, we'll just go, fuck, maybe this is the market telling me no.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm not made for this. Maybe I should stick to making beats. I've clearly seen some crazy success with that. Maybe this whole rapping thing isn't for me. Mm. But as we obviously know now, he pursued and he fucking hit it.
That's ultimate back yourself, eh?
Man. Like
when you see the level of rejection.
Yeah, dude, man, that's
you know, like,
honestly, 99% of the population.
More, bro.
Like, yeah.
Pretty much 100%.
Yeah, literally.
Because
this wasn't like a, oh, it's all right.
Nah.
Can you tweak it? This was like a no reaction to your best piece of self or product you can give.
Yep.
And it's not like it's your first thing.
Nah.
Like it's not like it's your first thing out of your catalog, your first beat or whatever, your first rap song.
Yeah.
You've been doing this
a while,
and you've been working with the best.
Yeah.
You've been producing for the best.
Yeah.
And so like they didn't even take that into consideration, you know? So like you know in yourself that you're good, you're great.
And there's some crazy shit.
Let alone the fact that you've got all this industry knowledge, you've got all these, you've got access to all this and whatnot.
Yeah.
And you've put it together and they're still not, you know, giving you the time of day and you just back yourself far out.
Unreal. Honestly, it's actually insane.
It is crazy. And it's inspiring. It's fucking, it's just a cool watch. It is just a cool
and
watch.
And that's one ep in, you know?
Yeah.
Five and to go.
One episode. Is it R3, I think?
I think it's 3. Might have got the
right. Can you send me the extra 2?
Ah, yeah. Exclusive, mate. Yeah.
Yeah.
It was like this. They're also going through Tom Brady's career.
Yeah. The draft reports,
too slow, or like, you know,
not a big arm.
And goat.
Literally
the greatest player to play the game, right?
So, do you know what it is? You almost like you need a little bit of that. Like,
yeah, of course you do.
And like the more you have, clearly, like the better you become eventually.
Well, yeah,
but it's also
a double-edged sword. It is a double-edged
sword. It's also like fucking shitting on you.
Yeah, I would say it's like almost like just relax, man.
I know, but think about it, guys. Like, fuck. Like, wasn't Tom Brady picked in the last round or something?
Yeah, bro,
last pick.
Yeah,
was he the last pick of the whole draft?
Yeah.
What the fuck, B?
Yeah.
Not that's fifth crazy. Round, sixth round, man.
Last pick of the draft. And so like, I mean, by the looks of it, the more you have adversity in your early days, apparently the better you become.
But to like, you know, that 1%.
I think you still have to have an element of being good at what you do.
Yeah, that's
true. Of course,
true.
You still got to be a Kanye West, you still got to be Tom Brady. So, but like,
let's say like you go outside your office and there's a skip bin outside.
Yeah.
And you come back from your car getting a water bottle and someone approaches you with a
business plan. Yeah.
And you've seen this guy pick out what's the food grading?
Yeah, the restaurant grades.
Restaurant grades from the skip.
Yes.
You see him do this. He doesn't see that you see him.
Yeah.
And he does this, he brings it out, and then he comes to you like, "Hey brother, how are you? Like, I'm a good man." He's like, "Yeah, brother. Just want to open a restaurant."
Yeah, well,
you know, I'm like, "Oh, that's good for you, bro. Back yourself."
Yeah.
And then let's say that, you know, that happens.
Mm.
And so this guy is opening a restaurant. Like,
yeah.
Do you, that's like,
absolutely.
Yeah, come on, mate.
That was his all falls down. He was playing all falls down for you, yeah, and you were ignoring him.
So you got to have some. Yeah, see, I'm just gonna say you got to have some sort of.
Nah, 15 years. So you almost now,
you reckon just. No, you need nothing. You just need people to say no to you.
Yeah. No, what you need is self belief. And because that's lots of it.
What I witnessed was self belief.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah. I think that's like such a paramount thing where people, even if they seem like, even if they are at the top of their field,
yeah,
they really don't know shit about anything.
Correct.
Do you know what I mean?
Correct.
This is a music executive said, yep. Nah,
no, to yeah, all falls down.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. And like, that's what you got to understand that.
Like even recently for us, like we've been in like a few different rooms recently and like having different conversations and like we think we're offering nothing.
Yeah.
And then we're just like, we might walk out of there feeling like, man, we just did nothing.
Yeah.
And then we'll have a conversation later with the person and we're like, they're like, their world's almost changed.
Exactly.
And we're just like, hang on a minute.
That was
like,
us.
That was us.
Yeah.
So like you're saying, like people at the top of their game still don't know everything.
Yeah.
So yeah, I hope my mate opens his restaurant on Ponsonby Road.
He will, dude. And guess what? You're getting invited to opening night.
Exactly.
Mate, I'll back this guy, you know what I mean? Because he's backing himself.
Yeah.
You need to. We almost have those moments though, right?
What's that?
Where like we've achieved something and we just want to have like a massive fuck you to the person that really didn't believe in you.
We've almost had those moments?
No, I feel like, have we all had them?
Oh.
Okay. I had one. Just
might still be waiting on mine, to be honest.
Yeah. Or was it when you, when you graduated with honors?
Yeah.
Or was that one? Because nice. We're going to get there.
Yeah,
we're
going to get there. It's because I don't know if I told you boys this. So this is back in the day of like when I wanted to be a pilot.
Yeah.
Well, I believe I still could have chased that dream if it wasn't for old mate here.
Oh, 100%.
Oh, it was a vision thing, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a vision thing, mate.
Right. Yeah.
It was no way. It was not. Anyway.
Like they had the vision to.
Yeah, just to say that. Anyway. Yeah. So.
Shout out to them, mate. Keeping us safe.
Yeah, 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 yeah. So, I had Matt's tuition.
Kumon.
Nah, Kumon. Oh. Like, it's a private one with this like dude.
Right.
And his. Yeah, I know what you're going to say.
I'm not going to say anything.
All kosher, mate, all right?
100%.
No traumatic experiences there.
No, I wasn't talking about that.
Anyway.
I was saying the calculation you made last week, I was just a bit off, but.
There's a reason, that's why I went to Matt's tuition, right?
Yeah.
Anyway, so, that's a side story. So, I remember he had two sons who went to med school or some shit like that.
Gotcha.
Right, this is a Sri Lanka guy.
Why do, can I just quickly interrupt you really quickly? Why do parents feel like they can siphon off the it's success of their kids?
Immigrant parents, it's completely bad.
What's worse is those fabricated success that siphoned off somehow?
Yes, I know.
Those ones get me. Those ones get me.
Yeah. Like, are your parents bragging about you?
Or I think what you're saying is like you hear other parents bragging about their kids, knowing well and truly their kids haven't achieved that.
Okay, yeah. Anyway, so I remember, so there used to be this other kid who used to do maths tuition at the same time.
Right.
And that, whatever his name is, I just call him Tuition Master.
Yeah.
He used to always fucking Dad. Congratulate the other kid.
Really?
And
man, you've had a few of these scenarios, man.
Yeah, always used to fucking bag me, right? And then I remember he berated me in front of that kid once, saying like, I was like, oh, you know, I wanted to be like a pilot or shit, and a pilot went up. And that guy's like, oh, you know, it's good to be realistic sometimes.
Damn.
I'm like 13.
Yeah, that's crazy. Let a kid dream, man.
100%. Also, he had a fair point.
Yeah.
You know?
He did have a fair point, but
and then
know.
I'm like, all right. And then he's like asking me after, and the kid's still there, the other kid. Mm. And then he's asking me, oh, like, oh, you know, what are you gonna, you know, you're taking maths next year, like year 12, year 13. And I was like, yeah, probably. He's like, oh,
the kid or the other guy.
The guys are telling me this,
right? He's asking me this, or he's to reconsider.
And I'm like, oh yeah, probably. And he's just like, oh nah, I think I just he's like, I don't, you know, you're not cut out for it. You just don't have the mind to like understand this.
Now I know why he has a gripe with plumbers, because the maths master said, could be a plumber, mate.
Yeah. So I'll fucking show you.
Yeah. And then he fucking, and then this is like multiple occasions, but like I'm compressing it to one.
Yeah.
And after, I remember he like pulled my dad into a room saying like, oh, I think you should consider other alternatives, not like university. It's just going to be a waste of money, X, Y, Z.
What the fuck?
Send you right? back to Colombo, eh?
Yeah, straight up send me back to Colombo. Anyway, fucking my dad fucking went off and shit. Anyway, at me, not him.
Yeah, I was gonna say, definitely not
my
at him.
My dad took his side yeah. completely.
Your dad's like, you fucking idiot, what are you doing?
100%.
I paid all this money for this.
There's no belief there. Yeah. And yeah, and then fucking, I thought, I was like, once I got my fucking honors degree,
yeah,
and fucking first class, baby.
Can we go see him? Let's go no, see no. him.
I wanted to mail him.
Yeah.
The booklet with my name on
do it. Do it. I reckon we should.
And I was this close to.
Nah, I reckon we do it.
Just to be like, fuck you.
I say we do it. Do it. Yeah. I say we hand deliver it.
You know?
I reckon we like put together a class action lawsuit against what's his establishment called?
Nah, I can't say that.
I reckon we definitely put together a class action lawsuit.
Yeah.
We
can at least get defamation.
At least.
Yeah. Oh no, sorry. The one thing that really pissed me off is he said, look at all my son does when he applied himself and shit like that.
And no, this guy's like, I had a Michael Jordan moment. That was all made up.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, that was exactly. Yeah. Completely
like,
false.
Yeah, I took that personally. He's like, I never went to tuition.
Yeah. No, that's why that's the one thing that stuck with me.
That's unreal, bro.
When he was just like, look at all my son does when he applies himself.
Yeah. See that level of adversity. You know, made you the man you are. Even if, like, say you had triple that, you'd be the best lawyer in all of the world.
Yeah, that may be pretty depressed though, you know?
Yeah, but like, it's just, you know.
You know, you shut up and get on with it, you know?
Yeah, fair enough, mate, you know?
I hated maths after that, you know?
Yeah, I feel that.
So it was kind of traumatic. But
yeah, even time Martin like asks you to do something, quick maths, you just, you panic.
I just freeze up.
Yeah. You know?
Just anything now, I just, it's good.
I've never had one of those.
Really?
Not that I can remember. Have you? I honestly can't remember. But I would absolutely love to have one of those.
Right.
Yeah. I haven't.
Yeah.
I haven't.
I'm getting mad disrespected right now. Yeah. Sorry to cut you off. Yeah. Nah, so I can't wait till we.
Yeah, no, like yeah. I'm in the process of getting to the stage where I can mail in my name on the whatever.
But like, it doesn't have to be to that extent. Like,
no, it's going
to
be to that extent.
Yeah, well and truly. 100%.
No, it's going to be to that extent.
I'm saying like in what has happened, it doesn't need to be to that extent. Did someone kind of say, oh, Marty's not going to make this TV shit?
No, there's every day.
Yeah. And when you didn't make the team, what was the reaction, you know?
Oh, I saw, you know. big chips, heaps of chips on my shoulder, you know?
Yeah, mad chips, mate.
And dips.
But, you know, we just shut up and get on with it.
Fucking oath.
Yeah.
Just quickly to put a bow on that one. Infinite self-belief is what's needed.
Oh, yeah. 100%.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And just a quick little sidebar. I was watching Stylebender on Brilliant Idiots recently. And
he was on Brilliant Idiots?
Yeah,
same day, same outfit.
Yeah, same outfit. That's why he was on Flagrant for a little bit of time because he had to do the other one. Him and Schultz and Charlemagne are talking about like they've been blessed enough to be dreamers.
Right.
Like most people, Schultz and thing were talking about like being immigrants, like you're always taught to like, yo, just strive for security.
Yeah.
Don't dream further than that. Just dream for security.
Yeah. Because,
which makes sense from an immigrant point of view. It's like, you know, we want you to, we've taken all the fucking risk. We just want you to be set up and secure.
It's like strive within these parameters.
Yeah. You know? But it's like,
be the best you can be within these parameters.
Yeah, exactly. You know? But we've been lucky enough to like, you know, be bold enough to go, nah, fuck that. I want to go further than that. I want to be like the biggest I can possibly be in my field and the thing that I'm passionate about, which is already a risk, and then to try and be the biggest possible in that field is even more of a risk.
Yeah,
100%.
And I think we should look at that as a blessing.
Yeah, no. Mm. I'm grateful for where I'm at the moment and where we're at.
Yeah. But the mentality.
Yeah. I'm grateful for that mentality. Like, correct. You know.
Yeah, but yeah, even though it's hard, you just got to believe in yourself.
Well and truly, and like at times it'll be lonely, like it'll be just you believing. Yeah, 100%.
100%.
Self belief's the hardest,
the loneliest thing, and the hardest thing.
Yeah, it's the worst and the best.
Yeah,
it's the biggest catch 22 out there.
Yes, but I will say if you find yourself going, if you find yourself truly backing yourself, you know that's the thing you're meant to do.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. If you find yourself doubting yourself, maybe that's not the thing for you.
Mm. Also, like you never know like what's next. You know, you don't know what you don't know.
Yeah.
So why limit yourself? Why stop? You know.
Totally.
Because like our whole thing with this whole thing we're trying to do, we're just like, what does failure look like to us?
Just stop it.
If we stop.
Yeah.
You know, and so.
We don't even have like an end picture in mind because we're like, that thing doesn't even exist.
We just know. We just know the picture has to keep changing.
Yeah. Anyway, all right, we're back. Quick battery change, boys.
Yes.
You guys been watching the news a little bit? That's
all I could do in isolation, mate.
Yeah. No. Apart from the X-ray to Oculus sessions you scheduled in, eh?
Nah, it didn't come in the mail on time.
Yeah. Right arm's looking a bit swollen, mate.
Huh?
What?
Both arms.
but the news, man, couple of things going on in the world. I don't know if you guys have kept an eye on it. Potentially, word on road is World War III might be happening. Might be on our doorstep.
Can I just say?
Please do.
I actually haven't watched the 6 o'clock news in a long time.
Me too.
But when I went to go visit parents, they were watching it. So I was like,
are they avid news watchers every night?
Avid.
Really?
Yeah.
Nice.
And I was thinking, you know, the world has just gone through a pandemic and we're just coming out of it.
Mm.
And what greets us?
A war.
A war.
Yeah.
World War III. And on top of that, what's even more crazy is one country is going to invade another country.
Yep.
Within the coming weeks.
Yeah.
And everyone's just like,
we don't give a fuck.
Can I just interject here and say, last year, around this time.
Oh, nah, see, that doesn't count.
No. But I'm saying, like, we were like, the pandemic, we thought the pandemic was over in 2020.
Yeah.
And so we thought 2021 would be better.
Yes.
And then we were heading into World War III then.
Which one?
That's the one with Iran.
Iran and the
States.
Oh,
yeah. Nah, so I don't take you guys seriously.
No. So this time last year, we were heading into it. And then COVID started to ramp up.
Yeah.
And then we're heading out of that.
Little pattern recognition here, mate.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah.
And so now you say we're on the tail end or like getting through the worst of it. And then another world war is
potentially
in the horizon.
Yeah.
So you're really just a bit of a...
but a flappy bird.
Yeah.
It's not one of those because Iran simply is not in the league.
Wow, that's crazy.
Hey. When I tell you I can't go back for a reason.
There's a damn good
reason. There's a reason I can't go back.
Yeah.
Told the boys.
Yeah, he flicks the switch.
Switch on the red, white, and blue.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Nah.
Game over.
It's fireworks, mate.
I don't think.
Maybe 14 hours.
I don't think you understand.
The Iron Dome, forget about it.
100%. Iran, gone.
Yeah.
Now, with Putin on the other hand.
Different.
It's a bit different.
Different.
Putin a pussy.
Yeah.
Okay, true. Talk to
us. Putin a pussy.
Talk about it.
It's because he's a pussy.
Yeah.
This is all a front.
100.
You know, he's 100. Just trying. He's peacocking it, if you will.
Okay.
You know.
A front for what?
No, like his this bravado he has.
He's
and,
weak.
You
he's
know,
a weak man.
Yeah.
And so this is a front for
it's all smoke and mirrors, mate.
He's
you know?
Like a strong man,
right.
But he's actually a weak
he's
man.
He's actually, okay, interesting. Yeah.
But sorry, just carry on before I...
Can I just ask quickly, so Russia is looking to invade Ukraine, or essentially go, snatch that back.
Yeah,
we'll take that, thank you.
Yeah.
Why?
why?
Yeah.
So they've been wanting to do this for...
Decades. Yonks, yeah.
I think the reason is... As people in Ukraine themselves view them as ethnically Russian.
Oh, okay, right.
So Ukrainians themselves see themselves.
They don't see themselves.
Sorry, you're telling. I thought you were asking.
Right.
A large portion of the population.
Yeah.
Right.
So they don't really see an issue with it.
Yeah.
Putin's like, well, if you don't see an issue, why
come on home, baby.
And then America's like, oh,
why does America care?
Because America cares
about everything, bro.
Yeah.
Interesting. Nah, there's got to be more to it though. They've got to have something that's
just America's ego.
Do you reckon? Oh, is it an ego thing?
It's geopolitical.
Yeah.
But like geopolitically ego-driven? Or
100%. Because
sometimes it's there's some like sustenance, like substance to it. Like
sometimes, but this is not one of those times. Essentially, it's pretty much...
There's no minerals in the Ukraine.
It's just ego, bro. So
interesting.
The majority, I'm pretty sure from what I've heard and seen, the majority of the people, like you say, are ethnically, they're Russian. And they're fine with the takeover.
Yeah.
And so the two parties involved are not so... I mean, there's going to be a bit of uproar, but then it's not like...
So why is
within
it
themselves, it's not World War III.
Right.
But then you've got the guys who want to call the shots, want to be the power brokers.
Right.
Don't get to dictate these terms.
Suddenly you've got a bit of conflict.
Nah, they got a kick in the door that they've put up.
Yeah.
Interesting.
You know?
America's had a stronghold in Europe for the past 100 years, right?
Yes.
And the moment they...
Have they?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
The moment they said, bro, you know there's hundreds of American...
Yeah, I know that, but does that make them... I thought they were just allies. I don't realize they had a stronghold. No, I didn't realize America was daddy.
Bro, America's daddy.
And Europe, though? All of Europe?
Nah.
All Europe.
China's daddy.
Yeah, China's daddy. America's pretend daddy.
Yeah, pretend daddy.
Yeah. This is all feelings, no facts, yeah. but continue.
But so I feel like what's happening here is every single time America's been like, hey, stop Russia.
Yeah.
They've done it.
Right.
Now, Russia's pushing back a bit.
Yeah.
America's not really doing anything. Russia's like, okay.
Go time.
This is a, you know, it's a facade. You're not actually going to do anything. You got all this military might, but you're not
gonna
do shit.
Really?
How far can you push it?
That's all it is. It's ego on both sides.
Interesting.
So this, the part that's flaring up,
yeah,
is the ego on the European side, because right. they're like, oh, he's put his tail up,
yeah.
We've put our tail up, and you're not anything. There's no pushback.
Yeah.
So let's see how much you know.
Yeah.
And that's essentially from what I gather. That's right. Where that's at.
So two things here. One, Ukraine's like, fuck, we're probably not the richest country at the moment. We joined Russia. Now, all of a sudden, we're part of a richer country, at least, right?
Yeah. I don't think their thoughts are that way inclined.
Yeah.
Because like they're almost like a Switzerland.
Who? Ukraine?
They're sweet. They're not like.
Yeah, but economically speaking.
Yeah, but I'm saying I don't think they're thinking like that. Oh, I think they're happy where they are. Oh, but yeah. They would be sweet with Russia, you know.
I would think it would benefit them majorly to be a part of Russia, economically speaking.
Nah, it would be the same.
Yeah, really? I don't think it'd be any
Russia's
different.
Russia's not a rich country, bro.
I know, but like it's richer than Ukraine, I think.
Nah,
no, nah, I think they look like they should be. They're people rich.
Right.
They're dense.
Yeah, I don't feel like there's a difference in quality of life between the two countries.
No, there's no. I think. I'm just, you know, speculating.
Mm.
I think it'd be a little bit better in Ukraine. They just seem. They just.
I know nothing about either country.
No,
I'm gonna be completely frank about this.
Why do you say that?
Yeah.
The Ukrainians, I've like, so the Iranian side of my family, they there's a few Ukrainians intertwined in that thing.
Right.
So like,
okay.
From what I've seen,
this guy's not taking you seriously right now.
It's like the reach of doom.
but he's using that as a generalization of the entire country as a whole.
No, but like, that's what I'm saying from what I've seen.
He adds a new nationality.
100%. We're up to like 17 now.
No.
Topic we're talking about.
Yeah, there's some link to his family.
Yeah, yeah.
I've.
You were talking about apartheid. You were just like,
exactly.
He and made like, hey, my uncle sense. Made Nelson Mandela.
My uncle Nelson.
My uncle suggested he go to prison.
Yeah, to really make a statement.
You know.
Yeah.
No. So on the Iranian side of the family, not my family members.
Right. There's some people, entanglements.
Yeah. No, not entanglements. There's people that have gone to Ukraine for studies. Like, I don't know how Iranians do it.
Left Iran to go to Ukraine.
No, they've just like they've gone there, and but I'm gonna drop you soon, bro. And see, now you got me thinking I'm lying.
I'm actually fucking, you know, do my own.
Yeah. Bro, just got into the University of Kabul.
Okay.
Yeah, a bit of a 4-year scholarship.
They're paying me.
Now, go on. They went over to study in Ukraine.
I'm gonna strip this all the way back and just be like, I've seen interactions take place.
Yeah, with Ukrainians.
With Ukrainians.
Of course.
On this Iranian side.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
I'll strip it all the way back. Okay? Yeah. And from what I've seen, they seem, I don't know, more happy-go-lucky than Russians that I've seen.
Right.
You know? Like,
where have you seen these Russians?
And also
from what I've seen, like, I'm not saying I've got my Samoan family in Russia and they send me videos, okay? Yeah. I've had that with the Iranians.
Yeah.
And the Ukrainians. So I'm saying, from what I've seen there, it seems more.
Also, you got to keep in mind, Russia is super diverse. So you've got like Putin's of the world, but then you've also got Hezbollah.
Yeah, but I've never come across like a Russian.
Hezbollah seems happy-go-lucky as fuck.
Yeah, but he's also.
I hope he's not going to war. protect Hezbollah at all costs.
100%.
Yeah. If anything, put him at the front and maybe I'm like, ah, let me stop this right here.
Yeah. Do you reckon, oh, America, yeah, because America loves them, eh? They can't.
Yeah. Oh, but you know, they love you until.
Until it's time.
Yeah, and that's the thing, so.
So, okay, so back to what I was asking, serious geopolitical discussion before he took over with whatever that was. I thought that Ukraine had some sort of political, I thought it was like a pivotal point where America was like, nah, we can't let them be a part of Russia because then that just gives them a lot of leverage.
That's so the whole thing. So they it's a geopolitical fucking leverage point. There's nothing like discernible about the country that's cool. Like, it's not like the Middle East with a piece of oil.
Oh, don't they like supply gas or something?
Yeah, I mean, they would, but it's like Ukraine's not a country that America's afraid to go on.
It's not, yeah, it's not a, it's not like a stronghold. It's not like, yeah.
Right.
Is, if America says Ukraine's yours, America literally loses so much geopolitical power. That's it.
In what sense? In the sense that they were like, we don't get to call that shot. Like,
exactly.
Yeah.
That's
essentially, what Ukraine is essentially like that last player in a trade, in a three-team trade.
Yeah.
Who ends up having, like, ends up getting bought out.
Interesting. I don't completely understand that one. Yeah.
Oh no!
Sorry, like, I was with you in the first half, and then you definitely lost me in the second half.
No, so like they're like expendable,
right?
Respectfully.
Right.
So like they're in that three-team trade, and like, oh, we just got to chuck this on the end of it,
right?
You know, so there's no need for the ego.
So why didn't they do that with Hong Kong?
It's all image. Sorry,
why didn't they do that with Hong Kong?
That's a
different story. Why? It's the big boys, right?
That's the real
the
daddy
big boys, right? Yeah. Okay.
Big boys.
Because the argument can be made, oh, because Hong Kong already belongs to China, so there's no reason for America to step in. But same thing could be said about Ukraine.
Well, the thing is, it's different.
How?
Because Hong Kong has clear ties to...
it's because his Sri Lankan uncle went to Hong Kong and like he's seen...
Okay. It was a British...
Colony.
Territory, right?
Yeah.
Why didn't the Brits stand up?
Because they only had a 100-year lease. The lease ran out, baby.
Exactly.
You know? But now, oh, okay, yep, I feel you. And so basically, America wants Ukraine to join his mate, NATO.
Yeah.
I don't mess with NATO.
Oh, you don't mess with NATO?
No.
What did he do? He just got too drunk that one time, eh?
Pretty much.
Yeah, hooked up with your missus or something. And basically be like, yo, son, come back. We'll look after you.
Yeah, pretty much.
Interesting, man.
Yeah.
Pretty cool reality TV series.
There you go at the end of the day.
Right,
because the whole thing's built on a stalemate, right?
Should we head over and document Ukraine's come up?
Yeah, we should do what they did with Jeen-Yuhs.
Straight up,
Ukraine's economic come up.
Might as just in Ukraine be like, hey, you remember my uncle? he went to study here.
Why you my uncle came and did that thing with the people?
No, Marta gets to Ukraine. I'm home.
Oh, well, where we were? Yeah. Yak smash.
Oh
yeah.
Man. All right. Well, fuck. We'll keep you guys updated because we'll be on the ground, on the front lines, if you will, with Hezbollah, making sure that it's a peaceful reconnection.
Yeah, that's all we wanted.
That's all you want. Yeah, peace, man. Come on, peace in the Middle East,
100%,
and in Eastern Europe. Turns out. But anything? Any other points from you guys?
No points. But I got a story.
Oh, please tell me a story. I'd love your
stories.
You think
that was unbelievable? The next one, you're not going to believe. So okay. I just thought of my uncle. You know my uncle.
Of course.
Uncle.
Yep.
I just thought of a story he told me. And like, it's a true story. So.
Strapping.
Yeah, I was going to say.
No, I think I'm blowing out of proportion. But like, okay, so essentially, when old mate came to New Zealand years ago, the Iranians that he came with, that were here weren't very financially stable, and like they, you know, English wasn't definitely not in the back pocket, you know.
Right. Yes.
And so like they were out here trying to make ends meet, just doing whatever they could. And so my uncle had this mate who was struggling more so than these guys.
Right.
So these guys had little to no English in their back pocket. This guy had little to no anything upstairs.
Okay, right.
You know?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
He left his country and he shouldn't have.
Gotcha, you know, like, he should have stayed. Yeah.
But anyway, he came here, made the trick over, and this guy was not up there. Like, up there, he was just not there.
Mm.
And so...
Was this guy you by any chance?
Well, probably.
So he was stupid.
Not stupid.
He didn't have his wits about him.
He definitely didn't have his wits about him. Like, he was a nice guy. He was like that kind of guy that was just a nice guy, but pretty stupid.
Mm.
And but didn't realize he was, you know? Most people don't. And so these guys are trying to like just go day by day trying to find jobs and whatnot, and they found their jobs, worked whatever, factory jobs, whatever, minimum wage. And so they're trying to save for a better life. This guy thinks he has like a hack, right? So he goes and does his grocery shopping and whatnot and like saves money. He's just like real frugal, you know, trying to better himself, like make himself financially stable. And then he'd always come up, like every now and then these guys would have like meals together and like a potluck and whatnot. And old mate would never participate or like eat with them. And this was going on for like ages. And my uncle questioned him about it one time. He said, why do you never like partake in our activities and meals and stuff? And he's like, he brought him over and he talked to my uncle like he thought he did something, bro. So he's just like, essentially, he said to my uncle, "I've got this hack. I've unearthed this aisle in the supermarket, and I found a way to get my food, get my nutrients, and just save money." One day, my uncle was like, oh, "Okay, like you want to see what this was all about?"
Yeah.
One day, old mate bought his potluck.
Mm.
And everyone gathered around, and this guy starts opening cans, and cereal.
Oh no!
And so he, for a while, had been consuming dog food.
Yeah.
The canned food and the kibble.
Right.
And so he was like eating this and rationing it, and he thought he did something. And then,
because it's cheaper?
It was cheaper.
I thought dog food was quite expensive.
I thought it was quite expensive.
Not Countdown food, bro. Not the Countdown stuff.
My question is, was there more? Is there more?
That's pretty much it.
My question question is, there's pictures of dogs normally on the cans. So what did he think was, because I know he can't read, but he,
I don't know.
Yeah, sorry. Really,
but oh, also
poor
when you're
guy, man.
But when you're going through an aisle of pet food and whatnot,
yeah, this
like when you're getting your breakfast next to dog treats,
yeah, yeah, common sense,
you know,
and also just like eating that and going, yep, that's good.
Yeah, but he thought he'd done something. He thought he had found his way out.
Yeah,
he thought he'd found his like his hack to saving.
Yeah, and did it work? It might have worked.
Nah, because if you could do that,
yeah.
Regardless of how much you save, you're not going to go anywhere with that money.
True.
You know?
True.
If anything, you're just going to upgrade to more luxury dog food.
Like a fancy feast or something.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Have you ever had dog food, by the way?
Nope. I had dog chocolate.
Oh, yeah. What's that like?
Disgusting.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I had like... It tastes whack.
Really bland chocolate. Yeah,
it's like one of those chocolate button things for dogs. Yeah, nah. Not for me, eh?
Yeah.
So I can't partake in that hack, unfortunately.
Also, like wet food. Come on, man.
Spam, you know what I mean? Spam, corned beef.
True, true.
But not.
I've never had corned beef, you know?
I need to make you guys a salmon.
Yeah, you guys big on the corned beef,
eh? Huh? Corned beef. Oh, yeah. Corned beef, cabbage, spaghetti. I don't normally have...
All in the same dish, or?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. I don't... Oh, not the cabbage in this one. So... There's like a...
I know corned beef and cabbage is a thing, right?
Yeah, so there's one variation where it's like corned beef, spaghetti, and onions.
Yo.
That goes hard.
Like tinned spaghetti?
Yeah.
Yo, yep.
Yeah, it's very weird.
I can, yeah.
But it goes hard. And then there's the cabbage. There's like the healthy alternative, which is the cabbage, onions, and corned beef.
Corned beef, yeah.
And just whip that up. And...
Into it. Oh, actually, before we close out, can we talk about why you hated on Marlon's mum's caramel pudding the other day?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I'll
tear it myself.
Oh, yeah, go tear it up.
No, you go on.
I don't know if you guys, I don't know how many episodes I've said the tone you've listened to, but we've mentioned Marlon's mum's famous caramel pudding on this pod a lot before.
Because it's a Sri Lankan delicacy.
World famous. It's a Sri Lankan delicacy. Exactly. Yeah. There's even a clip on it.
She's won like culinary awards.
Awards, bro. I'm pretty sure Gordon Ramsay actually recognized her for it.
Yeah. I'm baffled by that. Respectfully.
Yeah. And so...
I said respectfully. Come on. Come on.
And so I've had it a number of times before. Always, you know, hits fire.
See?
And Marlon had brought a portion home the other day. And I was like, I was excited. Like, yo, shout out to your mom. You know, this is gonna go down well. Yeah. Marlon had never had any before. And so this was his first time trying it. Yeah. And so, you know.
Crucial point. First time trying it.
This was his first time trying it. And so, you know, Miles kindly cut up generous portions for the two of us.
Generous, you know. And grateful. Grateful.
Top mine off. No time. You know, grateful. This is good. Oh, mate, you took a little bit longer than expected. What was?
My thing is, to be fair, I didn't hate it. okay, yeah, okay. I liked it.
Yeah.
But to be fair, I asked you for a small piece just so, because it was my first time trying it.
Right.
I've never had anything like that. And so.
What was the thing Martin said before where he was just like, oh, it's not the worst thing I saw. I've also seen a lot of better things.
Oh, Martin's feedback is the best there.
Yeah, no.
Oh, it's not the worst thing, but there's also a lot of better things out there.
See, you guys didn't give me time to like break it down.
What are you saying?
Because
it broke down on the table because you left it there so long.
Yeah, my thing was like, I was more than willing to try it, and I did, and I liked it.
That first bite, initial reaction, what did you think?
Yeah, what did you think?
Because the thing is, this would have been hyped up for you.
It was hyped up for me, respectfully. Yeah. And it didn't fall short or anything. It's just, I knew within myself, I shouldn't let your hype up
bleed
off it,
over to
bleed
you
over to me, because I knew the textures were going to be new, the flavors and all that stuff, and because I had never consumed caramel in that way.
Yeah.
Right.
Just
caramelized sugar.
Yeah. So I mean, is it my favorite dessert? No. hang on, would I have it again? Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, there's plenty left at home, so feel
because
free.
If I wouldn't have it again, then I think it's trash.
Mm. Yeah, fair.
But I needed to break it down, savor it, figure out the textures and whatnot.
Yes.
I do that with any new cuisine.
Right. Okay. Would you like a bit of crunch in there, maybe?
I probably would prefer a crunch.
A bit of crunch, maybe a biscuit base or something.
Yeah, you can't really go wrong with biscuit base, but that's because I'm used to it.
Yeah,
you know, if I keep going with this, I might enjoy it more.
Yeah,
that's just a cheesecake.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to get to.
You know, but like, you know, it's I've had like desserts that have been made with condensed cream and whatnot, but the textures have been different. So this was just a new thing for me.
Yeah, and you're just not a dessert guy in general, anyway.
I'm more savory.
Yeah,
but
so you were playing. It was a stacked card, you know, stacked deck. So.
Yeah, I'm grateful for it. Would I have it again? Yeah,
you know she's watching.
100%, 100%, and I'm not gonna lie.
And she specifically asked. She texted me.
Yeah.
What was Marty's reaction?
Yeah. She knows my view.
Yeah.
She wanted to know yours.
Well.
And when I said he thinks it's trash, she's like, "Oh, is that why he's taking so long on my car?"
Yeah. Yeah. But now back to the dessert?
Yeah.
Here we go. Grateful for it. Would I have it again? Yeah. Is it my favorite thing? No. Yeah. Is it the worst? No. It's just new.
That's okay.
Is it in your top five?
No.
Damn. Yeah, at least you're honest.
To be honest, I don't know 10 different desserts.
Right. Okay.
What's your go-to dessert?
Pussy.
It's a main. Probably cheesecake.
Yeah, cheesecake's good, bro. Undefeated.
Because you can't really go wrong with a cheesecake. Because I like those textures.
Okay. Same texture.
No, the base. Oh, no. But a bit of crunch.
Right.
I like something a bit firm.
Okay. Well, we're talking about desserts now.
Oh, sorry. Okay.
Yeah.
Nah, but caramel pudding, yeah. It's a dessert that...
Gifts or gifts?
Huh? Yes. Yes.
Nah. Yeah. Shout out to you, man. 100%.
No, no. Yeah.
Please, I love it.
So, is there any wiggle room there? Like, can adjustments be made to that dessert?
Probably not.
Or is that how it is?
Damn. He said probably not.
That's been passed down the generation.
Yeah, come on, dog. Decades. That one's a family recipe. Do you know how to make it?
No.
Dog.
How about I teach you a dessert?
That's what I was gonna say.
Yeah. I'll do that one, but better.
There we go.
I can't make dessert, bro.
Really?
My grandma says handwritten like recipes.
Dog, what are you doing?
Why don't you guys get into cooking, bro?
I would love to get into cooking.
No, you wouldn't.
I would love to do that.
Why don't you, like, why? I mean,
it's just a time.
Take out the weekdays. Why don't you try on a weekend?
Can I tell you why?
Please.
I'll tell you why, because I was telling this guy as well. By the time I am ready to eat, slash get into cooking mode or prepping mode, I'm already way too hungry, so I'm way too impatient.
So just time it.
Nah, too much. Too much. I got too much on in my day.
Nah, you guys should try it. It's good fun.
It looks like it.
And I mean, just what's hard with cooking one meal a week?
Nah, no, nothing. Nothing.
One meal a week.
No, here's the thing. So obviously everyone is familiar with the concept of, you know, HelloFresh.
Yeah.
Where they literally give everything to you.
Yeah.
All you have to do is put everything into a fucking...
In the right place.
Yeah, in the right place.
Yeah. Like at the right time. Yep.
Okay.
Even that, we're just like...
Yeah. Too much. We're considering it.
Too much.
So you're never going to cook?
No, that's not true. That's not true. I'm going to cook. Because I think cooking is rewarding as well.
You know, so you're waiting for a guy to walk into your life. Yeah.
Nah, see, I'm a little bit more advanced than that.
Well, you turn the kettle on, there's cooking for you.
Advanced in my mentality. In school, I'm about the same. In my mentality, it's like, I actually want to know how to cook.
See, I almost never want to cook in your house.
Why?
Because I don't want you guys to... Because you've left your home, so you've left your parents have been cooking for you. Your mum's, yeah. I don't want to be that for you guys.
Well, we are under...
As far as I'm concerned, you guys should not get to experience that.
Yeah.
You should not get to experience a home-cooked meal if you don't attempt to cook for yourself in your own home.
Don't get us wrong. We are under no pretenses that you are going to be there, because you've made it very clear that you don't want to be there for us.
Yeah. I'm happy to do that regularly if you guys cook once a week.
Okay, that's
or
fair.
Attempt to. What's but you don't attempt to. And so I'm just like, you guys don't deserve home-cooked meals.
Nah, you're right.
Your own home, you don't
spot on.
Give it a crack.
You're always more willing to help someone that helps themselves.
Yeah.
I get that.
But when you look at the sandwich press, you're like...
Time to cook.
Yeah. I'm just like...
That's a fair trade-off, on one exception. You eat the food that we cook.
Yeah. No, that's fair.
I mean, it is fair, yeah. But see, I don't want you guys to turn it into like a... Let's make him the worst dish possible.
Wow,
I don't want him to say,
we gotta eat it too.
Yeah, but I don't want this guy coming out. I don't want this guy coming out like, oh, hey, but here's a caramel pudding. You know, I don't want. See, that's too far.
Nah, because if you were to make it, here's a caramel pudding with corn chives, tomato sauce.
Actually, yeah, I don't think you should ever cook.
Yeah, facts, man. Because you preparing cooked food already is a bit,
bro. Never seen anyone have like a peri peri chicken, peri peri rice.
Yeah.
With a side of wedges, with
crushed up corn chips,
crushed up and whole
and.
And like condiments of doom,
ranch, fucking mayonnaise.
Nothing complimentary.
Nope, no compliments.
Your meal was no habla inglés.
Straight up.
That's what a typical meal for you is.
Yeah. The only thing that stopped me with the condiments is that I just
have enough. Nothing would stop you.
Yeah, you fucking ran out.
Yeah.
What is wrong with you, dude?
Your plate is a quintessential no habla inglés.
Yeah.
You know, you look at that and it's just no thank you.
Yeah, you're the opposite of Martin. Martin can't handle a glass of milk. You throw everything at your fucking stomach, bro. This man, crazy. Holy heck.
You're Putin with your food. You want to see how far you can push it? Yeah,
exactly. He wants to take everything.
You know, like noodle
canteen,
right? So like,
oh, bro.
Like even that Indian bhuja mix?
No.
Yeah.
Dog.
So I'm just like, I'm thinking, hey, you know, I kind of feel like something crunchy while I eat these noodles. These udon noodles. Snip, open the packet.
This man just, so we get regular ass food, right? Like just standard food that everyone just eats, you know, by itself. It's good. This man goes into the pantry or the fridge and goes, let me see how I can make this wild.
Yeah.
Let me see how I can mix this up. That's what he does. It's crazy.
Disgusting.
What? Like, and so you eat that and you go, yo, this is mean.
Yeah,
this is lit.
Yeah
that and not only,
he savors it as well. Like he'll look at a piece of chicken and he'll be like, oh, here's my corn chips. Here's my three condiments that make no sense.
Yeah.
And
yeah. Kid's wild, man. The kid's wild.
Yeah, we need to send this guy to Ukraine and see what happens there.
Yeah, straight up. Straight up.
But yeah, ladies, you know.
He is single.
I am single. So.
Yeah, and that's what you can expect.
And here's the saying, single.
Yeah. Did you say here's the staying single?
That's what I said. 100%.
No, but the positive is that whatever you do cook, his future girlfriend, partner, mate, it's all going to go down a treat. And if it's not, just add a couple of fucking corn chips to it and just drown it in mayonnaise. And then that's what it is. Everything's going to be good.
Yeah, you'll have like steamed rice and be like,
he's had that. He was telling me he's had that before.
No, he'll have steamed rice and be like, need some crunch, get some raw rice.
No, this kid's had mayonnaise and tomato sauce or mayonnaise and rice together. Bro, rice and mayonnaise. What the fuck?
Yeah.
What the fuck, bro?
I reckon we just end it there, eh? Before
I don't even want to take us out. I'm too baffled.
Yeah.
Someone else take us out. This is unreal. Marlon, you take us out.
Yeah. You know, he doesn't deserve to take us out. Once again, it's been a pleasure.
It's been good to be back, boys.
Yeah, it's been good to be back. Let's be more consistent, yeah?
Yeah,
let's
for
not
sure.
let my isolation lock us down again.
Let's not let COVID bring us down.
100%. It's been good to be back. Hopefully, it's a decent ep.
Oh, 100%.
We'll be back next week anyway. Feel free to interact. Feel free to tell us what you like, don't like, and what you want to hear.
Yeah.
And also, we're going to be having a crew drop.
Yeah, we are.
Within the week.
We should drop these at the top, eh? The crew drops?
Yeah, we'll do that.
At the top of the episode?
Yeah. We'll do that next time.
Yeah.
Here's one of the pieces.
Yeah. New crew merch coming this week.
This week.
Keep an eye out for it.
100%.
Some dope things. Marlon's got a piece on. So keep an eye out. Crew_apparel on Instagram. But outside of that, it's been Marty, Johnson, Miles. We're Set the Tone, and we'll catch you guys up next week. Peace.
Adios.
This the real one, baby.
I'm telling you, I love
Shy Town, stay up. Southside, Southside, we gon' set this party off right. Westside, Westside, we gon' set this party off right. Man, I promise.